Being journalist is not presidential. Fox News anchor Julie Banderas takes swipe at Trump after he criticized two of her co-workers from his once favorite network. Fox News anchor Julie Banderas has lashed out at President Donald Trump after the commander-in-chief attacked her newsroom colleagues on Twitter this weekend. President Trump, who regularly berates and belittles media outlets including CNN and NBC, turned on his favorite news network. Fox's White House correspondent John Roberts and Washington-based correspondent Jillian Turner. Reporters John Roberts and Jillian Turner. Never thought I'd say this, but I think Roberts and Turner at Fox News have even less understanding of the wall negotiations than the folks at fake news CNN and NBC. The president tweeted after watching other segment on the fight for funds during the government shutdown. Trump did not specify which aspects of the commentary by the Fox News correspondents he found problematic, but Banderas was having none of it and quickly rose to the defense of her colleagues, calling Trump out for bullying and insulting her fellow journalists. At Real Donald Trump, this is not right. I stand by my colleagues at John Roberts Fox and at Gillian Turner. They don't deserve this, no reporter does. They are doing their jobs and reporting the facts. They are not opinion journalists and deserve the respect from the at White House they cover. Banderas tweeted first. Our jobs are not meant to please others. But the office of the at POTUS ought not to be the one lashing out. That's not how this country works. That's not how freedom of the press works. Bullying journalists is not presidential. Period. She added. However, Banderas wasn't finished and ended up tweeting three more times in response to feedback from her original tweet. We can and do stand plenty of criticism every day, which is fine coming from everyday viewers. Our jobs are not meant to please others. But the office of the at POTUS ought not to be the one lashing out. That's not how this country works. That's not how freedom of the press works. The tweet resulted in a back and forth with some of her followers, which led to another defensive tweet from the Fox anchor. Be going on Twitter and insulting two of our journalists at Real Donald Trump is putting a target on their backs. In turn, his followers will then attack at John Roberts Fox and at Gillian Turner and support on Twitter. Bullying journalists is not presidential. Period. One follower asked by Banderas had been silent until now. Where have you been the last few years? Trump has criticized virtually every other reporter on the planet other than Fox. Where were you when targets were being put on their backs? I have always stood up for journalists no matter what network they work for. We all should support each other, Banderas affirmed in her final tweet on Monday. Trump has been known to call into his favorite Fox News personalities who are solely on the opinion side of the network, including Tucker Carlson, Sean Hannity, Jeanine Pirro, and the hosts of Fox and Friends. In a follow-up tweet, Trump wrote, "After all that I have done for the military, our great veterans, judges 99, justices 2, tax and regulation cuts, the economy, energy, trade and much more. Does anybody really think I won't build the wall? More in first 2 years than any president. Make America great again." Since running for office, Trump has waged a public relations war against news outlets whose reporting he doesn't like, among them CNN, NBC News, and others. Trump and his allies have branded those news organizations as fake news in an attempt to discredit their reporting. It should be noted that Roberts and Turner work on the news-gathering side of the Fox News operation, which is separate from the opinion commentary department. Trump routinely tears into reporters and tries to undermine the free press by accusing the fake news media of acting as the enemy of the people. In November, the White House was forced to restore press credentials for CNN's Jim Acosta after it stripped him of his pass following a heated exchange with Trump during a press conference. The president tweeted earlier this month that he had told White House Press Secretary Sarah Huckabee Sanders not to bother with press briefings, claiming without evidence that reporters often cover her rudely and inaccurately. This retreat from transparency and accountability sets a terrible precedent. White House Correspondents Association President Olivier Knox said in a statement at the time. Being able to question the press secretary or other senior government officials publicly helps the news media tell Americans what their most powerful representatives are doing in their name. Even Trump's most ardent supporters say that the president caved in agreeing to reopen the government even though he did not receive any funding for his planned border wall. Conservative columnist Ann Coulter called Trump the biggest wimp in the history of the office following his concession on Friday. Coulter, an immigration hawk and early Trump supporter, reacted with swift fury to Trump's announcement on Friday that he would reopen the government for 3 weeks without any commitment from Congress to fund a southern border wall. Good news for George Herbert Walker Bush. As of today, he is no longer the biggest wimp ever to serve as President of the United States, Coulter wrote on Twitter. Bush, who died in November aged 94, was widely ridiculed in office for going back on his "read my lips" vow not to raise taxes. Among the hardest core of Trump's base, many had expected the president to push forward with declaring a national emergency in order to build the wall, a proposal he had floated for weeks. Thursday's deal to reopen government came as a shock to this group and a potential blow to Trump's re-election chances. Taking to Twitter, Trump defended his move and insisted that an emergency declaration was still on the table if Democrats in Congress do not cut a deal to fund the border wall before the 3-week deadline. I wish people would read or listen to my words on the border wall. This was in no way a concession. It was taking care of millions of people who were getting badly hurt by the shutdown with the understanding that in 21 days, if no deal is done, it's off to the races. Trump wrote on Friday night. He continued to battle base backlash on Saturday morning, writing, single quote, 21 days goes very quickly. Negotiations with Democrats will start immediately. Will not be easy to make a deal, both parties very dug in. The case for national security has been greatly enhanced by what has been happening at the border and through dialogue. We will build the wall. In her interview with HBO's Bill Maher on Friday, Coulter said that all of her concerns about Trump would be forgiven if the wall gets built. Just keep your promises and I'm right back in your camp, she said. Otherwise, speculation has circulated that Coulter might mount a primary campaign against Trump. Asked about the possibility by Maher, Coulter joked, I'm against women.